everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Julia and it's time for a few of my favorite things. I actually have one item I'm totally confused about, but I've been using and some things I've been loving, and I don't have any fails this week, so that's an awesome, awesome thing. I like it when it starts like that. So let's just get into it. First, I know you'll notice I do have sleeves on today. It is 70 degrees and rainy here in Dallas, and that's kind of like winter to me, so I'm all bundled up. That's just how I roll. First things first, let's talk about the foundation that I have been using. It is actually, well, it's It Cosmetics Bye Bye Foundation. It says it's a full coverage moisturizer. It Cosmetics is a beauty brand that really pumps in a lot of skincare into their beauty items, which is one of the reasons I like them so much. I was very inquisitive about this when I heard about it. I saw an ad for it months and months ago. And I did order a bundle. It had a compact with a bronzer, blush, and highlight. This under eye concealer, and I believe a brush maybe. But if you have been with me for a while, you know I like the It Cosmetics CC cream, CC Plus cream. If you like that and you like that coverage, you'll like this better because it gives you more coverage. Now technically this is a full coverage moisturizer. I still do everything to my face that I do every other day. I do my serums and I do my moisturizer primer, then I go in with this. It's just telling me that it has enough skincare products to be a moisturizer. That's good enough for me. And again, complete coverage. I just like it. And I have worn it all week. No problems when it comes to going to title and sweating. It's beautiful. Absolutely love it. Let's see. Under eye concealer is the same as every other week, but here's the item that I am confused about. Last week I showed you the Laura Mercier Invisible Loose Setting Powder, the Universal. And I said it was burning my eyes, I mean, badly. Anytime I wore it, just made my eyes sizzle. It was painful. When my eyes finally washed away whatever powder I had, they would quit burning. So I was like, this is not good for me. For whatever reason, it wasn't working. So it was the weekend, and I did not have my contacts in. And I was like, you know, I'm just going to put it on. I'm just going to put it on because that's what beauty junkies do, or whatever you want to call us. We play in makeup, right? I was like, I'm going to put it on. I'll put it on, and I put a good amount on all around, you know. And I waited, and I was like, no burning. No burning. I was like, okay, well, let me put my mascara on. So I put my mascara on, and I was like, still no burning. I've worn it every day this week underneath my eyes to set my concealer. No burning. I have no idea why for 2 weeks it burned me and now it's not. I don't know. Maybe it's something else, but I haven't changed anything. This was the only new product that I had introduced. So I'm not quite sure what is going on, but it is amazing how finely milled this powder is. You put it on, you run your finger, and you feel so smooth, but you feel like nothing is there. It is amazing. I'm gonna go out and say I'm loving it. As long as it doesn't make my eyes burn. As long as. Crazy. To bronze up the face a little bit. the same combo I have used for months now. And I know we're not in summer anymore, but it's still just rocking my world, making me happy. I go in first with the Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer. Some people have a hard time with the smell. I love it. Absolutely love it. So I go in first with that on with a small angled stipple brush, just outlining, just so to speak, just kind of laying down the first piece. Then I go in with the Milani Baked Bronzer in number 04 Glow. I put this on with my Real Technique blush brush. And let me tell you, I just pretty much blow out the butter bronzer with this. Holy macaronis. That is so beautiful. And I will probably never finish, although I use it every single day. I absolutely love the way these two look together. Absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. Obviously, because I've been using that combo for weeks and weeks. Months, actually. Okay, eyeshadow palette. I do not have an eyeshadow palette this time because I've been using, grabbing one shadow to put in my crease. And it is the Milani shadow in the number 04 Bella Cafe. And this is a beautiful, beautiful brown color. These just go on so easily. They blend. It's not patchy. It's just a beautiful color. Just putting this in my crease, you know, putting a different color underneath my brow, just really has been pretty. So it's definitely been quicker to do my eyes this week, not pulling out palettes. So that's new for me. And actually, I've had this in my drawer for a while, and it's the first time I've used it was this week. So I'm really glad I did. Very, very glad. Let's see. Eyeliner. I'm still using the Revlon Colorstay. I go between the gray and this one, which is black and brown. It stays. Even when my eyes are a watery mess, this stays. When I'm at tidal and I am sweating, it stays. So it truly is fabulous. Then the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer is what I have been using in my brows. And I like it. Of course, mine looks very used. I don't even have the cap for the spoolie end. I use it all. This is in the color brunette, and I like it. Again, it stays very well. It doesn't come off sweating or anything else, so I really like it. And of course, you know, the Scandinavia that I use as a setting spray might have something to do with that, but you know, we'll just go with that. Okay, you guys, this week I have been using something other than Fix Plus to take the powder look away. Oh, and I'm so scared to say, but I'm really liking this one. It is the Pixi Skin Treats Glow Mist. This is available at Target, and I absolutely love it. It says it's nourishing, hydrating, and protective. It has propolis, what is that? I'm sure I mispronounced that. Don't hate me. Argan oil. So it's very nourishing for your skin, but oh man, this feels good when you spray it on. Here we go. It is, woof, not in the mouth. It is so refreshing. It has a beautiful mist and takes that powder look away and just gives you a beautiful glow, just like an angelic glow. It's beautiful, absolutely phenomenal. So I'm thinking, I don't know, it may rival, but I did order something from the Sephora VIB Rouge sale. that I'm thinking I'm gonna like, so but we'll stay tuned to that. So yeah, Mac better be careful. All right, lips. Let's talk about lips. We'll end with what I have on now. For a nude look, I've been using the Rimmel, the Kate Moss number 45. And let me take this off so I can swatch it. And it's just a beautiful nude color. And it smells good. Love the smell. Love it, love it. And then the NARS Audacious in Anita. Always one of my favorites. That color is just Julia wrapped up in a cute little lipstick case. Love it. And Bite Beauty Pepper is what I have on. Absolutely. God, I love these, and the smell drives me crazy. I love it, and it takes me back to my childhood, but I can't place what from. I don't know. But here is Pepper, in case you can't see it on my lips. All right, that was simple, right? Not too much, but really, really confused with this one. Why burn and then not burn unless it's something with my eyes? Who knows? But I'm liking it. It's nice to know that I am not different from everyone else I have seen on YouTube who raves about this stuff. Okay, so what have you been loving? Leave it down below. Give me a thumbs up if you like makeup. Hey, I love you all. Hope you have a great day.